They want to say, Pastor, put me at the hotel. Give me a break. Recompense for what you're doing. Amen. But you are a Christian, and I'm Christian enough to tell you, get out of my face. I ain't going to help you, you sin. Amen. He won't say it, but I'll say it. And I am saying it right now. Don't come to me with that mess. I tell you, get to step in. And pray for you too. Amen. Amen. Ephesians. Ephesians chapter 4. So people always like to use money and food and all those things and thinking that Jesus is supposed to keep increasing them while they're sinning. This is why we must have rules and regulations. Without rules and regulations, you're going to keep falling, people. And what's the best rule and regulation? It's the Word of God. Find your problem in here and decide, God, help me with it. Because it's all in here. I ain't found not one situation or issue I've been through that ain't in here. But you know what the hard part is? You know it's in here too. So you don't want to see it and face it. You rather just blindly walk by because truth hurts sometimes. And then you know, once God showed you, you got to pull it up by the root. Amen. See, we like to leave it hanging on the surface. No, it's time to pull that bad boy up from the root. Amen. And kill it.
Amen.
Believe me, you got a lot of weeds. Mm-hmm. And if you don't start pulling up those suckers, they're going to keep on growing over and over again. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Where else they go? Ephesians chapter 4. So we got to start pulling our habits and cravings up from the root. Amen?
Amen?
Or at least just ask God, help me to do it, Lord. Help me. Ain't no need me keep putting that other individual saying, look at them. I got people now, right now, outside of here. Instead of them saying, I'm wrong, I'm at fault, well, so-and-so did it. Get your focus on so-and-so. You need to look in the mirror and say, this is about me. I don't care if so-and-so doing it. Well, if so-and-so can do it, they do this on my job. But you're a Christian. You want to follow them or you want to follow Christ? Christ said, follow me.
Amen.
If you ain't following him, then you in disobedience. And you will receive the results of your sin. Amen. People think, I don't know what it is. They think about, well, God forgave me. Yes, he did. But you will receive the results of what you did. Just because he forgave you don't mean you ain't going to pay a penalty for what you did.
Amen.
Your penalty is you ain't lining up in obedience. Yes, he forgave you. Yes, he had cleansed you. Yes, but guess what? If you rob a bank, guess what they're going to do? Put you in jail. You can cry the blood of Jesus all day long, stand in their court with the money, but guess where you go? The jail. This. Do you go to jail and just think about robbing the bank? I can think about robbing the bank all day. But if I don't do it, I might go to jail. But the moment I do it, consequences of your sin. Consequences of your sin. Ephesians 4. Look at verse 17 to 19. It says, this I say therefore and testify in the Lord that you henceforth walk not as other Gentiles walk. Walk not as other sinners walk. In the vanity of their what? Mind. Having the understanding darkened, being alienated from the life of God through the ignorance that is in them because the blindness of their hearts. Amen. Who being past feeling have given themselves over unto what? Lasciviousness. To work all uncleanness with greediness. What is lasciviousness? Anything goes. I don't care. I know I used to hit it. Anything went. I wouldn't do certain things while I was sober, but let me start running out. Anything goes.
Oh, y'all know what I'm talking about.
Great. You go home, steal the baby's clothes, steal the parents. Steal the food in the refrigerator, the shelf. Steal all the jewelry. I love my mama. Mama, can I come in? She got to keep an eye on every place you go. Come on, because she know you're looking for something to take. And that don't make you feel bad? No, not while you're in it, it don't. It sure don't. Because that demon in you just says, I don't care. There is no conviction, compassion, gratitude. No, nothing when you're out there smoking. You have no feeling at all. You don't even care about dying. You don't even care. I used to get to the place after about 3 days of smoking. Lord, just blow my He wouldn't let it happen. So instead, I start sketching and seeing states and finding out, where can I get some more? See? Oh, y'all never hallucinate. Stay up long enough. You'll hallucinate. You will. Never mind, I ain't gonna go there. I leave you alone. I love you, right? Can I say just one thing?
Yeah, yeah. Go ahead.
God is still in love with him. You know why? He just fell once. I fell 45 times. And every time that brother fall, I'm gonna be here to catch him and kiss him and love him.
Amen.
Wouldn't you want that to happen to you?
Amen.
Amen. It's evidence that he's growing.
Amen.
Some of you, oh, I knew that was going to happen. I saw that was going to happen. Statistically, everybody relapsed.
Amen.
You just said a thank God caught him.
Amen.
That's all.
Amen.
He's been catching you and still catching you.
Amen.
You just say God caught you.
Amen.
All right, man.
Half of y'all peeling yourself, pissing drunk. Habits turn into cravings. Cravings turn into addictions. And addictions turn into demons. Amen.
Amen.
This is why we have to continually crucify our flesh before the doors become open that are hard to close. We have to crucify our flesh before the doors that were open become hard to close. Because you open the door for demonic oppression. That's why I said you need to kiss him and hug him. Because guess what? The door didn't close. How many of you, the door is almost shut? You didn't go through anything he went through. You still think you okay. But that door is ready to shut in. Amen. Amen. The more you participate, your willpower gets weaker and weaker. That's why you're in this house. Because every time you get weak, you come to friendship. Every time you think, I'm home, I'm going to friendship, that's you get weak. And God says, yeah, come on down here, I got a word for you. I got some other food for you to eat. And what really blows my mind, I haven't done this too, I complain about the food at friendship. But then I had to realize, God, thank you for filling my belly. It may not be what I want. I may not have my Louisiana hot sauce going. You know, I may not have the spices that I would eat with it. It may not be soul food. But you still gave me something. Especially when I only ate flour and water last week. Tastes good now.
Amen.
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 Might not smell all that great, but it's going in.
Amen.
All right, next thing, number three. Sin will rob your joy. It makes you sad on the inside. Sin will rob your joy and make you sad on the inside. That's when the pride level comes up and the devil begins to tell you, you're not worthy no more. You can't go back. You don't want people looking at you saying, see? It makes you even sad. The fact that you relapse ain't the problem. It's the emotional effect it does with you because your pride says, I'm not worthy anymore. I can't do it no more. I can't face them no more. Yes, you can. Because they're real Christians. The Bible said, open your arms and love them. Don't talk about them. Because you're only one puff away from falling yourself. Amen. Go to Psalms 51.
Okay, good.
Psalms 51. Psalms 51 and Psalm 32 are forgiveness psalms. Whenever you feel bad, you need to read this and cry out to God for yourself. Say, God, I said this prayer for me and I give it to you. Amen.
Psalm 51.
Psalm 51, wrong part A. Since you feel bad, you want to go do more. Because you don't want to feel bad. A drunk drinks until he passes out. A crackhead smokes until all his money goes. An addict shoots up until they pass out and probably need some adrenaline to be pumped in their heart. So they had to be woken up. Then they wonder why I woke up. Come on. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I'm just keeping it real with you. So sin will rob your joy and it makes you sad on the inside. Watch this. Psalm 51 verse 1. Have mercy upon me, O God. According to thy loving kindness. According unto thy multitude of thy tender mercy. Do what? Blot out my transgression. Wash away, Lord. I'm so sorry. And all the Lord has said, I knew he was going to do it before you knew he was going to do it. Give it over to me. I still love you. Come on back. Come on back. Look at what verse 8 says. Make me to hear the joy and gladness that the bones which thou hast broken me to. So that's God breaking you. Sometimes he'll break you to you. He'll have to send you somewhere. Me, it was the mentally ill hospital. After putting a noose around my neck, ready to jump and die. Smoking $1,000 worth. Because my daughter says she don't love me.
Amen.
See? Was it because I wanted to get high? No. The excuse from her saying, I don't love you anymore, Daddy. That gave me a reason to go and get high.
Amen.
Then as it began to run out in the hotel, I said, I don't want to live no more. Put a noose around my neck and jumped. Why? And he said, well, why are you still here? Because it hurt. I ain't dying like that. Then I wound up in a mentally ill hospital and met some nuts that were godly. Hey, how did that sound? I was sitting there talking to people. Funny. Some of them were so spiritual in my mind. They saw things in the spirit realm that I've never seen before. But see, my mind wasn't that they're nuts anymore. See, before I went in there, they were nuts. But now I'm sitting there with them, I'm a nut too, I'm not even listening. So I'm listening to them. Now, don't get me wrong, some of them folk in there need to pat the walls, there's no doubt in my mind, you know what I mean? But there were some people who saw angels who were just such on a different plane spiritually than I ever seen before. And if I wasn't open enough to receive what they had to say, I wouldn't have learned it. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Number four, sin ultimately leads to death and destruction. Sin ultimately leads to death and destruction. What kind of death? Death of a job, death of a marriage, death of your own human flesh, and death of relationship. Now, I've lost all of them. That's why I can write them down. I've lost jobs because of my sin. I've lost marriage because of my sin. I've lost relationships because of my sin. Amen. I lost friendships because of my sin. Amen. So again, go to Romans chapter 6. Sin will lead to death and destruction. Some of you can't get a job. You know why? Because you know if it's a job that requires you to feed the bottle, you won't fail. So ain't no need you going to the interview. Ain't no need. Soon they say, we are drug testing you. You don't show up because you know you won't fail. So you just caused death of a job. Then that results to death of the family. Then that results to what? Death of relationship. Sound like a trickling effect, doesn't it? Domino effect. Even this week, I got a contract. Now, when I worked for the Air Force, they didn't ask for no drug tests. You know, worked there over a year or something. Now, I got a 3-week contract coming up next year. The first thing I need them out, because it's going to be with the Walmarts and the Sam's Club installing computers for them. First thing they said was, you got to give us a drug test. And you know what the happiest thing I was able to say? No problem.
I know that's right.
I was happy to say, no problem. Normally, I'm a fat excuse. You know what, ma'am? I don't think I need this job this week. Because I know it's going to take at least a month to get the marijuana out of me. But I knew I could drink water and feed the cocaine out of me in 4 days. That's if nobody came by and offered me anything. Amen. I'm only being real. But now, what you know, it's getting cheaper to pull your hair. Hair stays in it, it grows like a tree. Just like you see a circle on a tree, that drug stays If there's hair on your body, they can pluck it and see how long you've been getting high. The only reason why companies never did it because it's too expensive. But guess what, people? It's getting cheaper. So now they ain't gonna ask for no pee. They gonna say, give me some hair. And they can tell whether it's been 6 months, a year. Oh yeah, you've been getting high, buddy. What's that, bro?
They get a hair test can go as far back as 7 years.
Ooh, yeah.
Good.
Yeah. That's why you gotta be clean. And for you podcasts, that's where you start. Blood smokers, you so smart blood smokers, that stuff saves you longer than anything else. And you wonder why. That's why you gotta follow. And guess what, you'll never move fast? Minimum wage. But McDonald's ain't gonna spend that kind of money. They will hire you and let you have the munchies.
Thanks, Bill.
I'm only telling the truth.
I don't look at
work. No, you're not. Right. Romans chapter 6, verse 23. Famous scripture. What does it say? Not in Galatians. Romans 6.
Wages in.
Yes, sir. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is Zoe through Jesus Christ our Lord. The gift of God is Zoe. Zoe is eternal life. Greek word is eternal life. So God says, stop this mess and I will give you eternal life.
Amen.
Zoe life. This bios is messing y'all up. Don't worry, it messed me up for years too. Amen. James chapter 1. James chapter 1. Y'all get anything out of this? I started a little rough. Because like I said, I came in feeling a little uncomfortable today. But I got to put me off. Amen. It ain't about me. Being a Christian ain't about you. It's about what God wants out of you. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. But I tell you, I'm going straight to prayer. I've been in prayer over the last 2 weeks, every day, every night. Amen?
Amen.
Over at Fresh Anoint, I've been going over there. They've been having 24-hour prayer, Jack. I've been going over there, just praying myself up a storm.
Where?
At Fresh Anoint. That's my wife's church, called Fresh Anoint and House of Worship. But they've been on a 21-day straight fast, pulling up roots and doing things. Now, do I agree with everything? No, I don't. But I do agree with prayer. And I decided I needed some prayer. Has it been working? Hell no! That's why I'm still going. What do you want me to be sure? No! I've been going for almost 2 weeks and I'm still angry. I still got issues and I still haven't given over to God. That's why I'm going to keep fighting and keep going.
Amen.
Because I need some results.
Amen.
What you thought? I went in there all suspicious of me. I come out, ooh, dooby doo. No! Son, you're trying to make me follow you. You better get back to following me.
Amen.
Yeah, I'm only being honest.
Yeah, go ahead.
I'm only being honest. So I'm fighting. Amen. Now you're going to see why I didn't preach. And God said, you're still worthy. Go out and tell the truth. See, I refuse to be a follower. I'm sorry. What did I say? James 1, verses 14 and 15. But every man is tempted when he is drawn away of his own lust and enticed. There you go. Then when lust has conceived, it brings forth what?
Sin.
And sin, when it is finished, brings forth what?
Death.
There you go. Sin brings forth death. Amen. Amen. The thing your sin should help you do is keep you from judging other people.
You gotta touch yourself.
The sting, oh my goodness. The thing your sin should help you do is keep you from judging other people. It takes a lot of work to sin. Come on, y'all. Y'all know.
Uh-huh.
You know, we like to put the label on, man, that bro can hustle. Man, he'll hustle.
Amen.
He been working. They don't come easy when you hustle. You got to beg from one corner to the next. The only reason why you can stand and talk about somebody else so bad is because your anointing is covering what you are really like. Now, let me explain that. The reason why you can talk about somebody is because God has revealed you yet.
Amen.
God's blood covering is still on you. You know, you who are still practicing certain sins and wonder why, hey God, you haven't showed me off yet. But you know what you make a mistake of doing? Pointing at somebody else. And God says, see, before you point at somebody else, I'm here to cover off of you.
Alright.
So that's the only reason why you have been revealed yet. The main thing, when you've been forgiven much, you should be able to forgive much. When somebody fall, you should be able to pick them up. Because your day gonna come. I like my bishop used to say, just keep living. It's coming. Amen. Amen. That's why you can't let the anointing take the place of getting daily in the presence of God. Prayer life again. A lot of you know the Bible, but you ain't got no prayer life. Amen. I don't know why you don't have one. You need to get one. Get a prayer life. Amen. Amen. You need to get a prayer life and let him bathe your character. Because see, when you in prayer, God will bathe your character. Well, Warren, I thought I need to read the word to get my character. Well, look, you need to read the word to get your relationship and the knowledge of God, but you need to get in prayer that he can bathe and change who you are. Amen. But see, we get in prayer and just ask, give me. Instead of getting honest with God, say, God, I love what I'm doing. Help me. And if you don't help me, I'm going to continue to do it. But he knows you're a hypocrite. There ain't no man walking around, a woman walking around, who don't have some form of hypocrisy in their life. I tell you, the greatest example of hypocrisy is when you first meet a man or woman you like. Amen. They're the most sweetest. They're the most nicest. The guy talked the most sweetest and humble. He's buying you flowers. She's cooking you a great meal. She's talking all sweet to you. Then you say, I do, it's over. Amen. Then you begin to live with the real one. Amen.
Okay.
You find out he pees around the toilet. You don't like him. You find out she don't pick up her clothes off the floor. You don't like him. Scotty! All
right.
Yeah, we got dogs. Amen. Now, let God bathe your character. Let the presence of God bathe your character. Amen. Let him bathe your conscience. If you ain't got no conviction in your life, I tell you what, you ain't saved. That's evidence that God is still in you. That if you feel bad about what you're doing, amen.
Amen.
And he still loves you. But if there's no conviction, God's wrong. Let the blood of Jesus wash your mind. Because that's the only thing that can cleanse you. I have been in this a long time. I've counseled a lot of people, been through a number of rehabs, ministered here, ministered there, and I found out the only one who can change you is Jesus.
Amen.
I could fight all day. I cried over people. I talked to people. I saw what people were going to do, and I couldn't believe some of them fell. But guess what? They're human.
Amen.
I didn't believe I fell.
Amen.
Amen. But I realized the only one who can help you is Jesus. So ladies, you can't change it. Maybe you can't change your lady. They got to make a conscious choice. That's what they want to do. Amen.
Amen.
Because one day, out of the presence, I can stink and smell bad. That's why you need to get into prayer a lot. Because one day out of God's presence, you stink. You smell bad. Because it ain't how your perfume or cologne smells. It's the sin that's on you. Don't you know your sin goes up to God in his nostrils?